What up? So the reason why I got on here is, which I haven't done in a long time. It's been years. But this morning I woke up and a friend of mine told me Mr. Solo from Gospel Gangsta had passed away. And man, I was just thrown back. It actually, the whole day has been a reflection, not just on Gospel Gangsta's music, the West Coast, growing up in the neighborhood I grew up in, not just that, but just how life is precious, you know, every second counts, you know what I mean? So I was hit. Like I was just like, and here's the thing, I never met the dude, but his music was so influential on my life. I can remember when I heard Eazy-E died, I was in a hotel room in Denver, and I was laying on the bed, and I had heard Eazy-E passed away. I'll never forget that day. I remember I was at work when Tupac was killed. Right? I remember that day. I'll remember this day. So, I mean, a lot of people are hip on Mr. Solo of Gospel Gangsters. Unless you're deep into Christian hip hop or you're deep into West Coast G-Funk, right? So I am, you know, so it was a big hit for me. And like I said, I never met the dude, but he always replied to my messages on Facebook. He wasn't a Hollywood dude, you know what I mean? Chili Baby from Gospel Gangsters. Never met the dude, but he's always replied to my messages on Facebook too. I respect these dudes with a lot. Man, these dudes are not Hollywood dudes. These dudes are neighborhood, right? I think, I can't remember when it was exactly, but I reached out to TikTok one time, and he had called somebody, and they had called me, whatever, because you know he's doing some time. And he rapped to me for like a quick second. This is way back, like 10 years ago or something like that. Huh? But anyway, so growing up, I grew up listening to, in the 90s, right? I grew up listening to G-Funk. Right? I know the real history of G-Funk, you know what I mean? So to some, you know, it's not a big deal, but to me, it was a big deal, you know, growing up listening to Above the Law, Cold 187, Big Hutch, creator of G-Funk, right, KMG, the creator of G-Funk, Total Chaos, Go Mac, Layla, these different individuals who created the G-Funk. So I was just heavy into that type of music, you know. And about 1997, I think it was, I was living in New Mexico at the time. I went to this church, and I heard my first ever Christian hip hop ever in my life. I heard this preacher. He was a youth preacher, and he got up and he rapped, and it was dope. It was dope. So I was just like blown away. Right, that's the first time I'd ever heard of it. But to me, it was cool, but I didn't really think I could, like, bump it. I just respected it because, like, he was really dope. His name was Dre, Pastor Andre Anderson. So I listened to him. I met some youngsters in the church, right? I met these young boys at the time, right? And they were telling me, gospel gangsta this, gospel gangsta that. I never heard of it. I never heard of it, you know. And I think I was at a Bible study. And this dude was leading the Bible study. Those were his kids. Those were his kids, right? So I was probably like 21 going on like 17. Like I was really immature for my age. You know, I don't even know. But I remember the youngsters in the church would always talk to me a lot more than the elders. And it's all you guys listen to gospel gangsters. So he puts on the tape, right, this cassette, right? He puts on the tape, man. I was just like, this sounds familiar, right? I'm like, that's cool. So I think the first song I had ever, I didn't know any of the names. I just heard the song was the testimony song. Remember, it went a song like this from Gang Affiliated album. So I'm growing up listening to gospel gangster rap. This is really like the first gospel rap that I received that I thought I could listen to. And you know, I mean, I think Tick's on the first verse, but I heard this song, I was blown away by it because it was real. It was real. It was a testimony about their lives. You know, Mr. Solo from Gospel Gangsters, Chili Baby from Gospel Gangsters, TikTok from Gospel Gangsters. It was a testimony about their lives. I could relate to it. And it was dope. It was dope production, dope rhyme, you know, like the poem. He showed me the tape, and on the tape, you know, it was one Mexican dude and three black dudes, and he was explaining to me who they all were. And at the time, I was just like, that's a dope song, cool. I didn't even think about it, but I was like, man, that's dope. So I left. A couple weeks later, we're doing an outreach, and this one kid has a dub of Do or Die. And when he played the Oh Double G's Go On, I was blown away. But this one got me. This one got me big time, because I never, like I said, this is all kind of new to me. This is all happening in a few weeks. And when I first heard Demon Killer, the Gospel Gangsters, that like solidified it. Now granted, I'm hearing all this stuff late. These records had already came out. I just never heard them. And from then on, boom, just Gospel Gangster fan. You know, enjoyed the music. The G-Funk behind it, the realness, the authenticity behind it. And at that time, there wasn't that many Christian rappers popping at all. I need this solo right here. I first heard this, I was blown away. Because he had skills. He had skills, man. A lot of cats don't have skills, don't have no flow, don't have no lyrics. Hooks is cool, but come on, man. You gotta come with some bars. I understood it, I received it, and I was just a gospel gangster fan at that point. Boom. So, I think about 1999 or something like that, they made the I Can See Clearly album. I listened to it, it was dope. That was the first CD, gospel rap CD I ever bought. I'm listening to that, I'm bumping that, constant. So that's pretty much it. I'm bumping this guy's cassette tape of a cassette tape of the quality of the songs that we recorded, that somebody recorded from him. I'm bumping that. I Can See Clearly Now, the CD. That's pretty much it. I don't really got nothing else. about 99. Like I say, I'm living in New Mexico. Chris Chicago was one of the first ever Christian hip hop DJs. People can say what they want. I mean, I was there. So, the Christian station, I think it was a Friday or Saturday night, they would play Christian hip hop, gospel rap. And then you gotta remember, so they're only playing gospel gangsters. They're playing some T-Bone. They're playing a lot of people from Great Tree Records. Little Rascal was probably the only one I really was feeling at the time. But they're playing like this certain, basically the same certain guys. Right? There wasn't that many people. And it really was looked down on at that time. A lot of people just didn't want to hear it. He brought gospel, I don't know if he brought him, but I know the Christian radio station, they brought gospel gangsters to Albuquerque. And I was sick. Like I had strep throat sick. I was so sick, man. I was holding my throat. I didn't want to go because I was sick. I didn't want to get nobody sick. But I ended up going. I put on my little coat and I ended up rolling to the fair. And I was basically just chilling by a tree, holding up this tree. And, you know, the gospel gangsters came out on stage. Little tiny stage, man. It was like a trailer, a flatbed trailer. They came out. Chili Baby, TikTok, Mr. Solo, and I can't remember the DJ or whatever, but they come out and they're doing all the new songs from I Can See Clearly Now, you know, and I, the album was barely dropping. I think they used to play a video all the time on this station that my youth pastor had, and just that album was something else. So, I hear, I basically stood there sick for the whole concert. It was dope, man. And they were G'd up all the way. They weren't. There's no phoniness. They weren't all Hollywood. They were all neighborhood. And they performed the songs. And I think they were throwing away like free singles in the audience, something like that. Anyway, I caught one or something like that. So that's all I'm bumping. They were on stage rapping, right? And all these little hyenas were in the front of the stage. And they don't know it's a gospel rap. They don't know that. So these ladies, they get up, they go on the stairs on the stage. And they're dancing. They're trying to dance with the gospel gangsters. They're trying to dance. But the homies wasn't having it. They came up the stairs. The homies came down the stairs. These chicks left out. Oh. Anyway, it was funny, though, because they didn't know it was a gospel rap concert. And so after that, they start preaching the gospel. And all them chicks split. All them ladies left. And them girls, they left. There was a couple little cholos in the front room, and I think an older gentleman and Mr. Solo, Chili Baby, took, you know, they prayed, laid hands on these guys, they prayed for them, you know, led them to the kingdom. It was dope, right? So that's the first time I'd ever seen him. I didn't know that'd be the last. You know, I bumped the record. As time went on, you know, I didn't really hear their music as much. They went independent at that time. You know, the internet was barely popping, so it wasn't like it was, you know, the stuff was out. But these Vatos, man, these dudes, Mr. Solo and Chili, always hit me up, always replied to my messages, you know what I mean, on Facebook, right? It was really cool. I remember, I think Chili Baby had his own website for a minute, and Solo, and they sold me some songs that weren't even coming out yet. You know, they gave me some heat. It was dope, man. These are just good dudes, man. That music was so influential on my life. It was the only music. You got to remember, I'm growing up on Above the Law. Above the Law. Above the Law is a epitome of gangster rap, for those that know. Most people won't, but if you were real with it, above the law, right? So I'm trying to, you know, strive to change my life. I don't know, you know, what to listen to. I need something real. This was the only thing comparable to that, to meet me where I was at. This was the only thing comparable to meet me where I was at. What's up, Slick? And it helped me, man. It helped me so much, because without those records, you know, without those records in those tapes, you know, those CDs, without those experiences, man, I didn't know what to look for. I was lost. You know what I mean? I needed some kind of music. I didn't know what. There was really no Christian music that I could listen to. I didn't really like any of it. But when I heard the Gospel Gangsters, I was in it. You know, and what used to piss me off, man, is when somebody would try to throw negativity on the Gospel Gangsters. Oh, you, that's oxymoron, or oh, they can't be a Gospel Gangster. Hey, if somebody ever said it to me, which was rare, I'd have to raise up on somebody. Like, I'm serious, and I'm not one of them dudes, but I'm telling you, man, I was like, it used to piss me off, because these dudes were reaching the streets. These dudes were reaching the streets, man. The gang members, you know, not just the church kids, that's dope, but what I'm saying is these dudes were out there reaching the streets until the end. That's the point, till the end. You know, and it really got me, man. It made me realize how much time I wasted. You know, this brother didn't waste no time. He got saved, he was in it, boom, he was off. You know what I'm saying? Without the Gospel Gangster music, I don't think I would have been able to overcome so much stuff in my life, you know, because I definitely needed a replacement of what I had, you know, certain stuff, music in my life that I had. Then there were other groups that I thought were cool, you know what I mean? Crossmoon was dope, you know what I mean? But what I'm saying is, I got this right away. And when they say he died, man, I had a rough day, man. You know, I had a rough day. I was thankful, you know, he was no more pain, right? But at the same time, it was like, dang, man. Like I say, and this is just a dude, like I said, I never met, but he was so influential on my life, like Tupac, right? Like Eazy-E, right? So I'm gonna remember this day when I heard about it, when I got hit with it, you know what I mean, whatever. And you know, my prayers go out to, you know, Chili Baby or Gospel Gangsters, you know what I mean? That's a good dude, man. That's a really good dude too, you know. Tick, you know, he's doing a stretch, you know. Gotta pray for him too. I mean, this Mr. Solo, his lyrics, his music, it was just something to believe in, you know, because we knew it was real, we knew it was truth. You can watch his testimonies on YouTube, you can watch his interviews, all that stuff like that, man. I wish there was more, you know. Yeah, man, so it definitely threw me back today, but in a good way, because it was inspiring to know that this dude, you know, comes off the streets. He was crippling, right? Gives his life to the Lord. He changes his life, you know what I mean? He starts making gospel rap, you know, and he basically infiltrated what the enemy had planned for wrong in his life. You know what I mean? He flipped it, you know what I mean? Because of God. You know? And that was just some. What's up, Ken? I don't think I never, I you take things for granted, man. This dude, Mr. Solo, man, his lyrics, man, it's good stuff, man. you know, much love and respect to Chili Baby, you know. And that's just a good situation, man, you know. Those three brothers, Mr. Solo, Chili Baby, TikTok, man, those three brothers, they created so much music that I'll still keep bumping. To me, man, it's, I'm telling you right now, I wouldn't have made it without those records, you know, the Do or Die album, the Gang Affiliated album, I Can See Clearly Now, Exodus, The Flood, Defenders of Faith. I even got Street Disciples. I got Street Disciples, the mixtape. I got that. I bought it, like, it was out for like a week, maybe like a week, and they took it down the website. I got it. So, like, I got that stuff, man, you know, and it's just, the reason why I'm saying all this is because, you know, life is just fun, you know, and you waste time at work, you waste time watching Netflix, you waste time in the gym, you waste time, you know, doing, oh no, those are all good things, but I'm not saying that they're bad things. But what I'm saying is to spend time with the people you love. And right now we're in this, you know, quote unquote, they say it's a pandemic. But, you know, it's a peace-demic, right? You got to find peace through all this stuff that they're spitting at you. You know, all these lies. And for me, you know, it's giving me a chance to, you know, to spend time with my youngest and get close to God again. Because, man, it's easy to fly left, especially when you like doing what you've always done. So it's easy to do that, you know what I mean? But I'm thankful, you know, for the few people that watch this, few people that will see this. I'll leave it up for a minute, you know what I mean? But I really am thankful, you know, for Mr. Solo, what the Gospel Gangsters did for not just Christian hip-hop, but what they did for West Coast hip hop, and they brought that G'd up flavor, but they brought it for God. That just, man, that was something else. You know, I got some unreleased stuff by the guys, and I'm only gonna play one song, I think. Let's see if I can find it. Just had it too, but let's see real quick. This was a white tee one, and I had the original color when they put it out on Amazon. I had the original Cal Fallon. I did the artwork. I had the original one, but this is dope. They go over trying to scan the week.
And they pouring out really. We got beats with the egg platoon. I'm a chief in the hood with a gang of goons. Gotta bang my phone. They tell my prank when I enter the room, like I did when he left the tomb. Only first class seats, credit card keys. Blessing to the world, sitting first class seats. That's why you can't tell me nothing. I'ma do my thing and keep stunting. All I need is mine.
Since it is a late night.
This is the form of a late night. It started snowing and we hate ice. The world is cold and we hate life. I know it's storming in the late night. Heavenly Father's in the frames in the late night. This is the form for the pain in the late night. I know you gotta do your thing in the late night. But it's something to maintain in the late night. I used to do the same thing. I became like
is on my mind, so I write me a rhyme for the ones late night of the grind. Welcome to the life and the time, sharp and white line. Lights are better than dark, I walk at night time. Keep your eyes open, never know what you might find. I see your man in the tombs, not in his right mind. End time, you put an end to your lifetime. That's why they label them criminals, they like crime. So many dreams close to the gate, like shine. Late night on the block, never a high shine. What is it ready to do? I got a toy to do. Six dudes, that's what the blue. Late nights, I enjoy the view. It was over when they brought the six shorties through. But I lived and I did what a warrior do. You hang back all blue, and I enjoy the crew.
This is the form of a late night. It started snowing and we hate ice. The world is cold and we hate light. I know it's storming in the late night. Heavenly Father's in the frames in the late night. This is the form for the pain in the late night. I know you gotta do your thing in the late night. Focus so you can maintain in the late night. I used to do the same thing, I became like. This is for the homies that I changed life. Never had a safe life, faces that I can't write. I reminisce about the days we ain't right. And though we always had it rough, we always had enough. I remember that my mama used to kiss the bush. It came hard, but at first I wasn't quite as tough. I had to knuckle up and stand on my own too. We used to crumb homeboy, cripple Pyro. That's when we started to carry guns and
you in the body, mm-hmm. Of the spirit, mm-hmm. This is what I want you to do. Mm-hmm. Well, I get picked up, so chop.
Oh,
Christian, but I still don't see skin. I come to the Lord, I can rush your way. I tell my secrets to the Lord, cause I trust no man. Keep my eyes open, all open eyes and see, and keep my mind open. Everybody knowing they believe it. The hood back cracking, bullets and residents selling. And with our country at war, what can our president tell us? And we the rest of our fellas already got me in cuffs, socking me up. I know only in God we can trust, but hey.
Nobody got this.
What he do, 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 what he cause they lie. I'm sitting for the have nots. I grab rocks, pay attention when I mention how we got the game locked. I witness for the savior, keep a gangster, that's major.
Rest in peace, Mr. Solo. West in heaven, Mr. Solo. Gospel gangsters forever.